Here's how I got fired as a consultant and what I learned from it. Sometimes in consulting, you're brought in to a client organization to validate an existing opinion that clients can use to lobby third-party stakeholders. For example, if a client wants to lobby an investor or a government agency, they would bring in a consultant, have the consultant write a favorable report or presentation, and then tell the third-party stakeholder, look, we got an expert, he agrees with us, so we must be right. It happens in consulting a lot. In my situation, I was brought in by one of the partners of this firm to lobby the other partner of that same firm. So the two partners of the firm were at loggerheads with respect to some strategic direction, and I was brought in under the pretext of providing my best opinion as to what needed to be done. But when I got the gig, the partner that brought me in tried to influence me or persuade me into writing a report and making a presentation that was in line with his opinion. And for me, I was just having none of that. The organization was my client, not the partner. So I provided my best opinion based on what I thought was the right thing to do, and submitted my presentation and a report. And that didn't go down well with the partner who hired me. So overnight, that relationship soured, and I was never called back to that organization. Now, on reflection, I realized that maybe I should have been a bit more clever in navigating through the political waters of that organization. But then I realized, look, that's not my job. I was hired to think and provide my best honest opinion, and that's what I did. And if the client thought that that wasn't good enough, then so be it, onwards and upwards. But what did make me feel really upset was that this was not a one-off engagement with this client. I'd been working with this client for close to 2 years in their various group companies on a whole host of projects. So overnight, that relationship was just cut off and I was never called back. That made me realize that, look, in consulting, shit happens. Okay, you're not going to be in a beach somewhere with your laptop sipping a cocktail with your client on the phone. That rarely happens. If you're an independent consultant, you got to be prepared for unforeseen circumstances such as this one. So the best thing to do is to build a sales pipeline. And in my case, I was lucky back then because I knew exactly how to go about getting my next client in 30 to 45 days. So if you're in the situation right now where you're looking for your next client over the next 45 days, then I'm putting together a small group of consultants who I'm going to help personally in creating profitable consulting offers and building a sales pipeline. And not only that, we're going to help you get your next client in 45 days, a client that pays you anywhere between $10,000 to $20,000 in revenue, provided you have a transformative service that solves a major business problem for the client. Would you like to join us? If so, then click the link, the first comment below, and schedule a call with me, and let's talk more.